क्लास 5, दिस इज़ योर वीडियो ऑफ लेसन नंबर 11, द एज ऑफ मशीन्स. इन दिस चैप्टर वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ डिस्कवरी ऑफ मेटल. वील ऑल्सो अंडरस्टैंड द इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन एंड वील ऑल्सो लर्न अबाउट द डिफरेंट सोर्सेज ऑफ एनर्जी अवेलेबल टू अस टूडे. सो नाउ लेट्स बिगिन विद आवर लेसन. द एज इन विच वी लिव इज कॉल्ड द एज ऑफ मशीन. मशीन इज अ टूल which makes our work easier. For example, a bottle opener. We use machines all the time and it is very difficult to imagine our life without them. Million years ago, early humans lived without any machines. They used their intelligence and made stone tools to hunt. Recently, humans have made rapid progress and most of the tools we use today were invented in last 300 years. Now let's talk about discovery of tools or metals. Copper was the first metal to be discovered. It was used in Asia to make better tools. Later they learned to make an alloy which was a mixture of two or more metals, for example bronze. Next metal to be discovered was bronze by mixing copper and tin and was harder than copper. After it, the iron was discovered. The discovery of iron was an important landmark in the history and it is harder than copper and bronze. Iron is used to make better tools and weapons. It is used to cut trees and clear forest. The hunting of animals was also made easier after the invention of iron. The discovery of metals was followed by many more inventions and discoveries. Now let's move to the steam engines and the Industrial Revolution. In earlier times, people traveled on foot and then on animals. The early carts were pulled by human. Later the use of animals was started. The discovery of steam engine made it much easier to travel from one place to another. Thus, the invention of steam engine revolutionized life. In 1769, James Watt invented the steam engine. Coal was used to produce steam from water, which helped in the movement of the engine. After some years, George Stephenson developed the steam locomotive. It was soon replaced by petrol and diesel engines. Faster transport and building and running of big machines was done by steam engines and thus it resulted in tremendous boost in industries. After the invention of steam-driven engines, goods now could be produced in large quantities. They were cheaper and of better quality. It is important to note here that the unit of power, which is Watt, was named after the inventor James Watt. Now let's talk about the Industrial Revolution. Big factories with large machines came up in the cities. People from villages came to work in the factories and the cities grew. The significant change from handmade goods to the machine-made goods began in the 18th century. Is called an Industrial Revolution. Now why it is called a revolution? Because of the large scale changes it brought out in our economy, society and culture. So students, here we can say the steam engine was an important invention that made the Industrial Revolution possible. Now let's talk about different sources of energy. Machine can be run using fuels. Over time, different fuels have come to be used to run them. Now, first source of energy is electricity. Several machines used today are run using electricity. It also lights our houses. Alessandro Volta was an Italian physicist who invented the electric battery for producing current. And after this invention, generators began to be used to produce electricity. And coal, diesel and petrol began to be used as fuels. The next source of energy is coal. Coal was the first fuel to be used in steam engines to produce steam. It is obtained from mines. Large amount of coal is used in power plants. It is also used to produce electricity. Next source of energy is petroleum. Petroleum is a source of energy from which petrol, kerosene and diesel are obtained. Gottlieb Daimler developed an engine which could be run on petrol. Rudolf Diesel invented the diesel engine as the diesel was cheaper than petrol and got its name from its inventor. Now students, all these sources of energy have the possibility of getting exhausted, which led the scientists to search for different alternative sources of energy. Now we are going to discuss about these alternative sources of energy one by one. First alternative source of energy is hydroelectricity. Hydroelectricity is the electricity obtained from flowing water or running water. In a dam, water is made to fall from a height on a wheel or turbine which rotates it and produces electricity. And thus, dams are also called hydroelectric projects. Next alternative source of energy is solar energy. It is the energy obtained from the sun. Solar energy is used in solar cells, solar cookers and solar heaters. The next alternative source of energy is wind energy. This energy is used to run windmills that generate electricity. A place with many windmills is called a wind farm. Next and the last alternative source of energy we are going to discuss is biogas. Biogas is produced by decaying of organic matter like animal dung, manure, sewage and other wastes that are biodegradable. Biodegradable are the substances or material which can be easily decomposed and they are not harmful for the environment. Biogas is an ideal fuel used for cooking, heating and lighting. So students, all these resources should be used in a limited way. In a limited way, and their unlimited use will cause their supplies to finish. Scientists are developing more alternative sources of energy for the future. There is an urgent need to replace the use of natural fuels with alternative fuels. Thank you.